on a show early, a man on a demolition mission. Oh, Kulabdam lined him up with a left meteorite. The onslaught, the barrage, puts the bang in Bangkok tonight. The never say die attitude, the no retreat, no surrender.
Aziz Alali, the French under 63.5 kilo champion, WPMF European champion, has beaten some great Thai names, including Nopakit, Farmongol, Sindan, Katmu 9, and Kontak Sipunmi. 6-11 record against Thai opponents is Aziz Alali.
Go!
Nice sweep there from Alali.
Go!
Sending an early message to Sangmanee. Sangmanee, southpaw stance. Look out for that left leg power. Sangmanee bounds up to his feet. Will not score as a knockdown, of course, it was a sweep. Effective though, it means that Sangmanee has to pick himself up off the canvas, so it mentally deflates him a little.
He also scores clean techniques, so just like a combination lands, you land a nice right hand or a big kick, it's going to score kind of the same way in the judges' eyes. Here he goes, Halali's nice and light on his feet, trying to move around. Our stat sheet, it has them dead even at 180 cm, but I think Halali has a little bit of a height and reach advantage.
Overwhelming support for Sangmanee on the one fantasy game. Most playing it on the one super round, 89%, a massive 89%, the highest percentage of any contest on tonight's card. Favours Sangmanee for the win over Aziz Alali. Sangmanee left roundhouse kick, trying to force Alali back into that corner. Cracking round kick again, and a good catch and sweep there from Alali. This one at a catch weight tonight. Sangmanee's won titles across so many weight divisions. Rajadamun champion at 108, 112 and 115 pounds. Lumbini champion at 105 and 124 pounds. S1 world champion at 110 pounds. Oh, look at that nice little step across and try to fire the left hand. From Alali, trying to manhandle and bully Sangmanee at the moment. Still hooking there from Aziz Alali.
He's doing a good job of just mixing up his attacks. He's not giving Sangmanee the same weapon over and over again, so he can start to develop his timing. What we've seen from Sangmanee in the past is a gigantic left kick and immediately following in with the left hand. Let's see if Halali can mix things up enough to keep Sangmanee on his back foot. Pushing forward a lot right now.
This is Muay Thai in 4-ounce gloves. Knees, elbows, all the good stuff. Halali, southpaw stance now for the French Moroccan. Switches back to orthodox. Inside leg kick from Halali. And we go to the towels at the end of one. Sangmanee pumps his fist in the air. He began competing as a 6-year-old, a child prodigy, trained under his dad, who was a former Muay Thai athlete. Look at the beautiful sweep there. Took out the support leg, did Aziz Alali. It's beautiful technique, catch and sweep.
Yeah, that was three beautiful dumps from Halali. He's really mixing up the weapons nicely. Look at that.
How do you score the first round? Some very surprising stuff from Aziz Alali. Maybe you give the first round to the French Moroccan, who opens up with a wicked high round.
Really important in these early rounds. Typically I've seen Sangmanee start slower in that first round. So if that round went to Aziz, it's a good little way to get on the board and get there early, because now the pressure is gonna be on Sangmanee. Now Sangmanee is starting to push forward, getting a little bit more aggressive.
As I said earlier, Sangmanee's never lost to a French opponent, 3-0, including a win over Rafi Bohic, who he beat in Thailand last October. 6-0 overall against European opponents. Looping a right hand there from Aziz Alali. Last time Sangmanee finished an opponent was in December. He TKO'd Martin Avery of Ireland in the second round in Pattaya. Good inside leg kick from Alali.
see Sangmanee thought he was going up top and he started to twitch back. He's looking for that lean back defense, but the Halali was starting to go to the leg, touching up twice on that leg kick.
Sangmanee's had some big wins in his time. I say in his time, he's 22 years old, but he's been around for so long. Beat the likes of Pompey Akchuk Mongol, Super Katnu 9, Muay Thai, PK Sunshine Muay Thai Gym. This goes on, good cutting inside leg kick. Sangmanee trying to take out the support leg again.
You see the balance. I think Sangmanee understands what that's coming. He knows how to deflect it properly. With the balance shown by Sangmanee. But I like the mix up of weapons. Coming from Halali. He's doing a great job of changing things up in his system.
We spoke about Sangmanee winning that 2012 Sports Writer of the Year award in Thailand. In 2015, Aziz Halali won the Muay Thai TV Awards Fighter of the Year award. Time there from Sangmanee. Halali inside leg kick. All the accolades that Aziz Halali has beating Sangmanee tonight would be the highlight of the French Moroccan's career. Tries to curl the right hand over the top. Goes back to center ring. On the balls of his feet. The stance of Halali, you could almost envision him in a taekwondo uniform. Right behind the ball, the finish drops the hands a little lower. He's very straight up. He's not crouched down through the brow too much. Sometimes he slips into that taekwondo stance. Taekwondo guard. House kick there. Final seconds of the second round of three. Halali's certainly oozing with confidence. It's been a good performance from him. One more round to go.
That round, very close. Both these rounds are so close. You've got the forward pressure coming from Sangmanee, but the artistic display coming from Halali. Just a lot of back and forth action. There it is. See, he's starting to time that high kick. Sangmanee sees it coming. He has a beautiful lean back. I love the strategy.
Sangmanee from Chakiri in northeastern Thailand. Nearly died. 2014, Sangmanee, he was poisoned before his match with Thanochai. Southpaw starts at the gold. Halali will switch between Southpaw and Orthodox. A cagey character is the towering French Moroccan.
Beautiful push kicks and defensive strategy coming from Halali. The way he's able to keep Sangmanee away. Sangmanee's can always push him forward. He sees that head kick coming, so I like the strategy of going low to that leg kick from Halali. He usually just hustles people around, especially inside that clinch, throwing people around, ragdolling them, if you will. Halali's not getting an inch.
Nice tough. You see Halali tried to hook the leg and dump Sangmanee. Sangmanee said, no, no, you're going down. Solid left hand there from Sangmanee. Halali moves into the clinch range. Some knees here from Sangmanee, trying to fold him in half like origami. Halali turns him against the ropes, chance for the elbows. It's a knee again from Sangmanee. These will score well for the tie.
Look how he's putting those hips into that. He just drives that knee right into the midsection of Halali. He's scoring a lot of points with these knees right now.
Sangmanee, who comes in having won his last five between May and October this year, all by decision, is he 90 seconds away from another decision win on one Super Series debut. And there again, the taekwondo stylings of Aziz Halali. You're seeing it quite clearly. Very much WTF taekwondo, the type of taekwondo you see in the Olympic Games. Quick shuffles, low hands. This is not a clear-cut decision by any stretch of the imagination, folks. I'm telling you now. You could not tell me clearly at the moment who has won this one, who is winning this one. It could go either way. Three judges are ringside. Scoring on the 10-point must system as Halali lands up. Elbow and then throws a spinning hook kick. More of that taekwondo style coming in from Aziz Halali.
but it eats up a little bit of time too, getting back up off the canvas like that. Ate up about 7 seconds. Halali needs each of these seconds to score points, because look at this aggression coming from Sangmanee. He's trying to score a lot of points with his forward pressure.
Referee Onari needs to remove the project armband off the left arm of Sangmanee. It's come loose, it's around his wrist. Doesn't see it though on his blind side. Sangmanee, left roundhouse kick. Final 10 seconds of the round of the contest. It looks like we're going down to the judges. As Halali puts the fists up, he believes he's won it. Final flush of roundhouse kicks. Halali draws a short straw. We are going down to the judges. And your score, folks, wherever you're watching, in over 140 countries, on the air everywhere. Have it for that man, Sangmanee, Santiago Muay Thai. Have it for Aziz Halali.
I don't know, man. You can't let your opponent off the hook, even when you believe in your heart of hearts that you won that match. You have to utilize every single precious second you have.
Let me tell you where it comes from, though. In the stadiums in Thailand, in the final 30 seconds, even sometimes the final minute, the guys will take the foot off the steam, take the foot off the pedal, and back off each other and dance around the ring so they don't do damage.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Sangmanee Satyan
Muay Thai has arrived in one super series. The 22-year-old seven-time world champion sends a very strong message.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.